So, good evening, guys. Do you have any ideas about what we should review tonight?
Yeah, I have no idea.
Oh, I have no idea.
Yeah?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
If you could love the world with a flick of a switch.
That's right.
That looks good, man. Thank you.
All right. Mm-hmm.
So I guess now we are reviewing what appears to be Merlin's Ale. This is brewed in the Scottish Borders by Broughton Ales Ltd. Here we go. Merlin, right there. And apparently right here. I got a new bottle opener. Finally, I'm opening in style.
It's good.
Scottish Ale.
No more mishaps.
That's right. And this beer is actually, I think I read, 4.2% alcohol.
That's pretty low.
So it's lower than,
yeah.
You know, even your Budweiser.
Now, enlighten me, because I'm not very familiar, if you gentlemen know this. Do we know exactly what Scottish Ale?
We have no idea.
Okay. So we'll edit this out totally later.
Yeah. Yeah, we're going to edit this out crazy. All right, so this is completely blind, because we don't even know what we're drinking. So, cheers, guys. Cheers.
Wow, it smells like, what is that? Like, oh, man.
It's hard to identify.
It's such a familiar.
It has, to me, like, it's a grassy smell.
It's a little piney, I feel like.
Yeah.
But it's not as bright. It's kind of a muskier.
It's a hint of the smell that you find in a Belgian.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like a yeast kind of bread.
Yeah, it is a bit yeasty.
Yeah, it's very yeasty. It's somewhat sweet on the nose.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like a musky grass smell to me.
Even like a dark
it feels like, you know, when I used to walk into my grandpa's study, you know, and the smell of like lingering cigar tobacco and like all his old rugs and his books and stuff.
Yeah. Like, mm-hmm. Looking at this, it doesn't look like it could have all that in it.
Let's
all right, well, let's drink it.
Very mild.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Super light.
Very light.
Really light. Good flavors, though.
Yeah.
It's not light like a, you know, macro. Not like a Budweiser.
But it's interesting because I'm used now to drinking all these high ABV beers that it's pleasant to have a really low one that's just kind of enjoyable to just ease down.
Mm-hmm. It's not very bitter. It's not very sweet. It's
actually kind of watery.
It is a bit.
Yeah, I'm maybe not totally into the taste. Very into the smell of it.
Mm-hmm.
I think actually that's what I enjoy most when I'm actually tasting it too. Is, you know, getting that breath of the of that. It's really nice aroma.
Yeah, the aroma is definitely a lot more enjoyable than the taste.
It's a little it's got a little yeasty taste too. It is a bit watery. And I don't know, it's like this kind of astringent, like almost chemically flavor.
This
seems like there. I don't know, that I'm not a huge fan of.
The malt in this gets that very slight butterscotch or toffee. The sweetness that I do pick up is in that realm. That's
yes. Yeah. Yeah, that's right. And I mean, I think that's part of the what makes it.
It's so
somewhat enjoyable
in the background, though. It's a very light beer.
Yeah.
For me, I'm not totally impressed with the beer,
mm-hmm.
and I think I'm going to go C+ on this. It's just not very much there.
Yeah, I'm going to go C. I feel like it's, at least I was hoping there'd be something there,
mm-hmm.
but it's just not very flavorful.
Yeah, it's difficult for me. It's like I said, it's really smooth and easy to drink. It's got good flavor for the alcohol percentage, but it's still extremely lackluster. And I think comparing this against like all beers, I'd probably give it a C. But if I include this in the craft categories, I think I might even go lower.
Oh yeah.
Just because it
yeah.
it does lack the flavor profile. So I don't know. Depending on C to C minus, C minus then.
Yeah.
But I did get
D.
No,
probably C minus is me.
I did get my grandpa's study out of this.
Oh, well, that's good.
And
nostalgia.
It is Merlin's ale, so I don't know. My grandpa was
sure.
Merlin, but
yeah,
it's kind of interesting.
Maybe.
So
you should try it. Tell us what you think.